Okay, this is like the second time I've had to do this video. This video is about women and the feminine quality of women. And I think that that is one of the essences that is missing in today's society. And that is our capacity to be feminine. I think that over the years, women have literally had to man up thanks to the feminist movement and the sexual revolution, that we've literally had to man up. We've replaced femininity with sexuality, and in that replacement, we've become sex objects. So, you know, my argument is that as women, we have to look again at femininity. And femininity, for the most part, does not mean that we have to be weak, or that we can't take care of ourselves, or that we can't work, or, you know, all of those things that were positioned to us in the early onset of the so-called feminist movement that literally has went down the tubes, that we had to do in order to be able to maneuver ourselves in, quote-unquote, a man's world. My thing is that as a woman, you know, I think that being feminine is not a weak stance. It's an essence of being a woman. I know I've been very aware of, you know, just how I've grown over the years and the things that I've been through and how I've literally manned up, you know, had to be hard, had to talk tough. This is what I thought I had to do. Had to talk hard and had to talk soft. Talk, you know, to act hard in order to assert myself. Well, I've learned that that is not the key when we're dealing with men, you know, on a male-female basis, is that we as women have to retain our femininity, that softness, which is in contrast with the masculine. This, in turn, gives the men, our men, the responsibility to protect us. This is what makes a man wants to protect you, is your femininity. Not the fact that you're weak or you can't pick up a bucket or a bag of potatoes or carry a box or take care of yourself or go out and work. It is not that. It is the feminine in you that addresses the issues within a man that makes him want to protect you from other male aggressors, because that's basically what the protection piece is all about, is protecting the feminine against the masculine aggressor that may come into your house or camp or wherever you are. And I think that this is where the feminist movement kind of usurped that and replaced that with sexuality. So we moved from being feminine, which then meant that you were weak, you couldn't do nothing on your own, you were relegated to certain types of things that you could do in the society. And the feminist fight was to assert the fact that you could do some of the jobs or some of the things that were relegated to men at that particular time. However, what I do think what it did was it kind of took away the feminine quality of a woman and made her as hard as a man, which means that for the man, he now feels as though he doesn't have to protect you, that you can protect yourself from other aggressors and any damn thing else. And, you know, I think that that has been detrimental, particularly for black women. And so as we are now in this era, we can get back our femininity. And we can still manage to be able to do all the things that our Creator has designed us to do. It doesn't relegate us to the bedroom, the kitchen, or the birth room. It brings out a quality in our men. That's what femininity is all about. It is in contrast, or it is the complement to our men. So we have to really think about our femininity and exactly what that is. You know, I just really, really want to stress that to be feminine is not to be soft, not to be able to do and take care of yourself. Being feminine is just the essence of a woman. And as I stated, I think we've moved away from the very essence of womanhood. And even though we may, you know, talk about being a divine goddess and all that kind of stuff, but when I hear some women talk about they're the divine goddess, I don't feel the feminine quality of them. I mostly hear, you know, I'm a divine goddess, and it sounds more like, you know, a male type assertion. So I think that what is key and crucial is that we get back to the feminine principle, that we get back to what it is to be feminine. And I think that we could be feminine and still have the things that we want in life, to be able to do the things that we need to in life. And in return, what we will get from our men is the respect that we seek, the protection that we need, and the love that we desire. And I think that instead of us being looked at as sexual objects, which is what the feminine and the sexual revolution produced, is that we must get back to the feminine principle of being a woman. And I think it's really important that we do that for our very survival. Because right now, men don't know what the hell to do with us. You know what I'm saying? They don't know whether we were, you know, whether to open the door for us or not. They don't know whether to walk on the side of the street, you know, with us or not, or to walk behind us or beside us or in front of us or not. They don't know what to do. So I think that as women, we have to bring it back to the natural way of how we are as men and women. And, you know, to be able to do the things in the society that we feel we're capable of doing, but we could still do those things as women, as feminine women, and not as feminine men, basically, or woman men, I'll put it like that, not feminine men, because those are the effeminate men, but as women, as feminine women. And this, hopefully I'm getting across to you what I'm trying to say. And what I will be exploring on my show on Blog Talk Radio is that we're going to talk about femininity. We're going to talk about the feminine principle and how that affects the family and the community at large. And that as women, or feminine women, that taking care of ourselves, taking care of our bodies, the softness of our skin, the shape of our bodies, loving that, loving ourselves as women. I am so grateful that I came here as a woman. I love being a woman in spite of all the shit that I have to go through as a woman, which is societal in part. I'm still grateful that I'm a woman, and I know and understand my power as a woman. And I'm saying that as a woman who exerts her femininity, it is not to be used to manipulate men, which has been one of the biggest problems, I think, when it comes to women and their exerting their femininity. It generally has been used to manipulate men. And I think that as a wise woman, you use your femininity to enhance your man, to strengthen your man, to bring out that masculine quality that he has inside of him to protect you and to protect the family. So hopefully you got some out of this video, because I came straight home from work and did it because this was on my heart today. And as I said, I will be having this discussion on Blog Talk Radio about this very subject. We're going to get back to the feminine principle. We're going to be women. We're going to be women to our men, and not men to our men. A man with a vagina. So this is Queenie Fama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Hope you got something out of it. Peace.